Mr. Hawke was handed the blame.
There was a time when ministers resigned because something they had done was proving a distraction for the government.
Well, Mr. Young was in Sydney awaiting his fate.
Hawke government minister Mick Young quit when he forgot to declare a large stuffed Paddington bear at customs, only to be exonerated and returned.
And I'm pleased that I've been vindicated.
At the centre of the debacle is the Minister for Health, Mr. McKellar. He's admitted importing the set last October.
Michael McKellar was a Liberal minister in the Fraser government who had to go because the black and white TV he declared was actually a colour set.
A colour television set brought in by the then Health Minister, Mr. McKellar.
The Minister for Customs went too for handling the situation poorly. These days, it's hard to imagine two scalps for a colour TV. It's become a point of stubborn determination not to give your opponents a scalp.
Can the Prime Minister confirm his emissions reduction minister has been embroiled in four scandals this year?
For the past week, Energy Minister Angus Taylor has been in deep trouble over his involvement in distributing doctored documents to attack the Lord Mayor of Sydney over travel expenses.
I reject absolutely the suggestion that I or any members of my staff altered the documents in question.
The damage has spread to engulf first the Prime Minister and now the Attorney General.
Did the Attorney General seek advice from his department or agencies, including whether the Prime Minister calling the Commissioner one of his best friends gave rise to a further conflict?
Mr. Speaker, the descriptions of that call provided by the Prime Minister and Commissioner Fuller have been absolutely accurate.
Angus Taylor has become a wrecking ball through the integrity standards of this government. His list of scandals through this year have variously involved Barnaby Joyce, then Josh Frydenberg, and then the latest dodgy document scandal has brought in Scott Morrison and Christian Porter, the Attorney General, who very unwisely involved themselves in a call to the New South Wales Police Commissioner about a criminal investigation into one of their colleagues.
Crossbench MP Zali Steggall says it shouldn't have to fall to the police to investigate the fraudulent documents. She says the whole saga is exactly the kind of thing a new National Integrity Commission would investigate if it were given the right powers.
I do believe this is the kind of issue a National Integrity Commission would deal with, because we're talking about a minister in their role as an energy and emission reduction has written publicly to the Lord Mayor of Sydney, has at the same time provided a copy of his letter to the Telegraph, clearly with an intention of publicly intimidating and harassing, I would say, the Lord Mayor of Sydney over their actions.
The test for a resignation used to be not just a minister or someone responsible to him or her doing something wrong, but whether they were distracting the government from the job at hand. And that is exactly what has happened to the Morrison government. This morning, the Prime Minister held a press conference to announce a new foreign interference task force, but...
Mr Dunn, you're a former police officer. Would you have appreciated or taken a call from the Prime Minister into a matter that you were investigating?
Well, you're talking about the dark ages when I was last a police officer.
None of this has helped reinforce the message the government keeps repeating in question time.
In a stable and certain way.
Stability and certainty.
Stable and certain.
Stable and certain.
Stability and certainty.
Stable and certain approach.
In a stable and a certain way.
On Saturday, the government quietly put off its contentious religious discrimination bill until next year.
Means there's not support for the bill.
Hardly a surprise after last week, when One Nation shocked the government by voting down its union-busting bill. Now, in the final sitting days of the year, the government is full of big talk about bringing the bill back, but it knows it won't come to a vote until next year. It's still deep in negotiations about the Medivac legislation. And, in a sign of how fragile things remain, the government took the unusual step today of using its numbers to stop Pauline Hanson's proposed dairy industry code being debated in the Senate.
I'm sick and tired of procrastination that happens in this chamber.
Fearful that the debate would expose splits within its own ranks.
The debate has expired.
Things aren't going smoothly in the House of Representatives either, with the PM sometimes overreaching in his attack, as he did today, claiming Labor had not been able to land any free trade agreements.
Every single time, it would seem, Mr. Speaker, we have to drag the Labor Party kicking and screaming to support these trade agreements, Mr. Speaker. They tried to start plenty, Mr. Speaker, but they couldn't conclude any.
My question is to the Prime Minister, and it goes to his answer to my first question, where he said, I quote, "They tried to start plenty, but they couldn't conclude any about trade." That's not true, Prime Minister, is it?
I'm happy to acknowledge that some were concluded under the former Labor government.
It's still not clear what will happen to the Medivac bill, the legislation that gives doctors more power to order medical transfers of asylum seekers held offshore to the mainland. It was forced through early this year against the government's wishes. Now the government's efforts to kill it hinge on its negotiations with crossbench Senator Jackie Lambie.
Denying people medical care is un-Australian. It is inhumane.
The government is also anxiously awaiting the release of economic data on Wednesday, which will tell us whether the economy has slid further and about the likely fate of the surplus. But the biggest question looming over the politics of Canberra as the year ends is the fate of Angus Taylor. Both the Prime Minister and New South Wales Police Commissioner Mick Fuller insist there was nothing wrong with Scott Morrison's phone call last week about the investigation into Taylor and the City of Sydney doctor documents affair. But consider this. The Commissioner has suggested the outcome of the investigation could be known this week. Will that be known before or after Parliament rises? And either way, how good will it look for either the government or the police?
Hi, I'm Lee Sales. Thanks for watching this story. If you'd like to watch more of 7:30's stories, they are on the left of your screen. And tap on the button below to subscribe and get the latest from ABC News.